Here for game two. This hand is fine. Doesn't have disruption for his combo, but it's pretty fast, so let's keep. I mean, we have a turn one drop, we have two big cards, we have the lands, so it's gotta be better than a mulligan to six. The question is, what do we play on turn one? Signal Pest or Vault Scourge? Or Drum? Drum it is. That'll help me play around the Lightning Bolt. And I'm gonna use the mana on the next turn anyway. I'm never gonna attack with whatever creature I play. But on the next turn, yeah, it's gonna be interesting to see what I do. I mean, I could just dump out Steel Overseer and Signal Pest. It's probably gonna present the fastest clock. It's definitely going to be Steel Overseer. He might have a way to deal with it, but if you want to try to get it out, you have to get it out quickly. And is it Signal Pest or Vault Scourge? Probably Vault Scourge, actually. If he doesn't have anything, then the lifelink is going to be huge to raise his Tarmogoyfs. Besides, Vault Scourge currently doesn't have a lot of friends. It may have more on the next turn, but oh, Lightning Bolt Arena, too bad. He only has two cards remaining in hand. That's good for me. Nux Opal is also good. Control Z it is these days. So I'll say might as well just attack first. I'm not gonna sacrifice everything to an Arcbound Ravager and put it on Vault Scourge. Not when he can have Ancient Grudge or Lightning Bolt or whatever. Though I guess this way I show that I don't have Cranial Plating, which means that he's more free to, well, use that information. Well, whatever. And I guess he can now, I don't know, spell snare this, but that's fine. Okay, he doesn't have anything yet. I mean, if his hand is two lands, then I'll win the damage race. If his hand is Pestermite, Splinter Twin, I'm probably not gonna win. If his hand is Anger of the Gods, well, then that's just gonna be annoying. A big Ravager, I guess. I guess I can make a big Vault Scourge too, that might even be better. Well, definitely sacrificing the Signal Pests. Interesting. Like, if I sacrifice the Vault Scourge here as well, then he's gonna attack me with Tarmogoyf. We both have a 4 power guy, mine is a Ravager. And we're gonna go into a damage race, which I may or may not win, probably will win, but whatever. I'm gonna be behind a little bit. His Tarmogoyf is gonna be 5 power. He might be ahead in the damage race then, especially when he can tap down my Ravager for a turn. Whereas if I put counters on Vault Scourge, it's gonna be worse against Ancient Grudge, but better against everything else in the damage race. I think I like that play the best. Yeah, I can just make 6 counters here, make it a 7 power. It's definitely good for the damage race. I guess 7 or 6 power doesn't really matter that much. So I can keep a land around. Yeah, I can keep Citadel and a Glimmer Void around. Yeah, I like this line. Best to have a big life linker than to have, well, a non-life linker. And I would certainly like to use the ability. So now we could still play land. Now, if he had Lightning Bolt, then he wouldn't have played it this way. It doesn't really matter. So now he's dead in two more attacks. He has one card in hand. I hope it's not a cryptic command. But some random cards I can beat. Snapcaster can beat it as well. I mean, he can snapcast a bolt and, I don't know, kill something, but I'm still winning the damage race here. And he needs to top deck something on the next turn. He did Snapcaster. How do I see what he bolted? I have to check the chat somewhere. Alright, what he Snapcastered. Yeah, it's Lightning Bolt. I guess I might as well activate his Nexus to try to jump block. I'm not sure if that's necessary, but I mean, if he has a bunch of Pestomites in a row to tap down my Volt Scourge or something, it might help. I'd rather jump block now when I have like 2 mana up. If it was some 2 casting cost cards on the next turn, then. Yep. Yeah, but I'm not jumping with the Signal Pest. That gives me one more life. Then I can jump with it later. Besides, if I draw Ensoul Artifact, then now it's still lethal. Oh, plating. Ugh. I guess if I hadn't jumped with the Ignite Nexus. Oh well. Yeah, fine. As I said, he needs something good here. Ancient Grudge will do it. Or Cryptic Command. Or just any flyer. Or Deceiver Exarch that taps down my Volt Grudge for a turn. Or nothing! Yay! We did it.